So here we are down beneath the church itself, St Cuthbert's Church up behind us, and down here St Cuthbert's Well, or as they say locally, and very often in Northumberland they call it Cuddy's Well. Cuddy, it's got it, this sort of affectionate name, yes, Cuddy's Ducks, Ida Ducks, because they sort of slept under his bed on the Farn Islands or whatever. And this is a traditional holy well. Do you think this might have been the starting place of the church?
I suspect so. I suspect this is the reason why not only the church, but Bellingham are here.
So, would it have, might it have been, would it have started with them, or do you think there would have been a holy site way back in...
Who knows?
Who could tell?
If it was ascribed to him by the early days, there were stories of two miracles here. In the first century story, chronicled by Reginald of Durham, who's a bit of a dubious source.
Yeah. From Durham after all.
Durham, yes. They were trying to own St Cuthbert. But what happened was, the three miracles all concerned a poor but pious bridge builder called Spreeock.
Spreeock, the bridge builder?
Number one, his daughter, Ida, was on the... He was a feast of St Lawrence. Didn't go to church, it was sewing a dress at home.
Shocker.
And she was paralysed.
Yeah.
He prayed, and St Cuthbert appeared and said, take some water from the well. Ida took it and got better.
What?
That was number one.
That's a nice one.
Number two, also to do with Ida, it's Ida's wedding day. But on Ida's wedding day, a heartless bailiff took poor Spreeock's single cow and gave it to one of the tenants.
The beast!
And he prayed to St Cuthbert, and lightning struck the tenant's house. The cow survived and came back to Spreeock.
I'm looking forward to the third one.
The third one. There was a two thieves stole Spreeock's axe, which is very important to the bridge builder. Mm-hmm. One was Walter the Flander of Flanders as a sidekick. And he paid some cuts to hand. The axe took on a life of its own and chopped up the two thieves.
What a marvellous well it is. It is a fantastic thing. The atmosphere. I mean, this is 18th century discovery.
Yes.
But the source has been pouring out since the beginning of time.
Yeah.
Do you think it's called Cuddy's Well because he came here to preach here? Or do you think it's because of the story of his body being carried?
Who knows? Who knows? I don't know.
I like to think of
him.
I like to... I mean, you hear stories about his genteelness with the locals and the way he walked around, just like Hayden had done before him, to come and preach to people.
Yeah.
And it seems to me that this is the sort of place that he might have chosen.
Yes.
A lovely little hill, a little holy well. Well, it's such a lovely atmosphere, hasn't it?
Oh, should we go and see the church?
Let's do it.
Right.
Let's do it. Mm-hmm.